just finish this bead real quick, sure, and then I'll do it. You can't really put down the bead and go back to it unless the kiln's up to 950, and then you can let it kind of settle in there and go back and introduce it back into the flame, but I forgot to turn the kiln on.
Oh, I have a scenery of these shorts and t-shirts.
She's either walking the kids to school or studying. It's a special occasion.
And
they have she's talking to me about expensive purchases.
When she does get
we're teaching a workshop in November. And there's scholarships available through the Arkansas Craft School. It's also got college credits, school credits available. This is through Ozarka College as well. So you have 5 days. And you get glass history lecture along with the slides and everything.
You guys just string these alone, or do you put some little beads on each side?
In the event that someone wants an entire necklace, well, he'll make an entire, like that box right there, he'll make a set of those.
Wow.
They'll usually have a small bead in between, but that comes up like 2 or 3 times a year because it's kind of a high-end. But also just setting it with silver as an individual pendant is quite nice. Just wear it with any kind of silver chain or black cord.
You might have to put more spacers in between those just to get it to go around your wrist. Sorry. Can you tell?
Shh. I was trying to be crazy.
Just need a little more clear on both sides. The bead shop.
There's a comedian that does a routine about going to Burger King and they hand him a cup. He said, I didn't remember filling out an employment application. Fix my own drink.
Well, okay.
Should I put 2 or 3?
Have you ever been to the bead shop in North Little Rock, Argenta Beads? It's really nice.
No.
You can go in there and work on your own projects.
So is the bead place near where the old antique mall was there, the Argenta Antique Mall?
It's really close to the farmer's market. It's just a little bit north of that on the same road, Main Street. It's on the corner. I think it's 15th in Main. Right across from Firewater Liquor Store.
That's how we find it.
It's right before the bridge. There's a bridge there as well.
Wow, look what
there
she's doing.
See how fluid it is at that moment. But then it stiffens up really fast. This is a twisted cane, and I'll use this for a decoration element in the bead. It's just one of the many pre-made components. You know, you have to make them in advance of the bead itself. But you want to keep it straight. There we go. I'll make a hollow bead with one real quick. You can't really count your beads before they're hatched, though. Anything can happen at any time. You can lose control of it quite easily. But this is a stainless steel welding rod. And they have to be straight or your bead will not be round. And then there's nice clay coating on the tip to keep the glass from sticking to the mandrel. Otherwise, you'd never be able to string the bead. It would have that metal through it all the time. And I'm going to make 2 thin-walled discs.
That's beautiful. You see on this particular bead too, I cut the marinis open on the edges, so when you hold it up to the light, it's almost like a whole different piece. It's like a little. Yeah.
You have to twist as you lay it down, it helps it continue its pattern, otherwise you'll unwind the twisted cane. I'm trying to get it to lay down in a perfect circle. Other side. This one's just opaque colors. This one was made by someone other than me, probably my son or Tom, because they have a tendency to twist it opposite of me. So Beaubead, BeauxBead.com is his website.
We're back in the last millennium.
We're dinosaurs.
Fossils. Yeah.
But he demonstrated it in France 2 days ago. And then he teaches in Denmark in 10 days. He's getting a little bit of good traveling out of the international aspect of this medium. Now I'm trying to seal those by connecting them in the middle. And the air inside will naturally expand because it'll be hot. This is a style of bead I've been doing for, I guess, about 12 years. And lattachino hollow beads. And it takes a while to get enough of them to make a whole necklace. There we go. Now it should start rounding out a little bit. There we go. That's a wrap.
Awesome.
You can't tell the colors until it cools.
It's relatively round. Put it in the mailbox.
Yeah, you're going to have a class.
I think that's enough. If you can, I hope you measure it on the inside.